The main attraction of the Hyperloop system is its supersonic speed. Virgin Hyperloop has trialed its first ever journey with passengers in the desert of Nevada. The futuristic transport concept involves pods inside vacuum tubes carrying passengers at high speeds. In this video, we will learn about the pod structure and levitation theory. Let's start with its structure. Aeroshell. The aeroshell is made of carbon fiber panels, and is used to test the wide variety of interactions within the pod structure. Carbon fiber is lightweight and stronger than steel. Chassis. The chassis is the main part of this pod or capsule, which is made of aluminum and carbon fiber respectively. Levitating chassis. The levitating chassis is made of structural aluminum, and houses the propulsion system, and magnets for levitation and guidance. Its design is similar to a Formula One car. Levitation. One of the key features of the Hyperloop vision is the phenomenon, where the gravitational force on an object is counteracted by an upward force. The object is able to levitate without touching anything else, such as track. When the pod moves with respect to the track, the conducting guideway will experience a change in a magnetic field, because of the Halbach array moving with respect to the track. Do you know the Halbach array? It is the arrangement of a magnet. Magnetic field lines runs from north to south, normally symmetric in both side magnet. But, if you rearrange this magnets like this, that creates a stronger field on one side while reducing the field on the other side to near zero. In this footage, you can get a clear idea. According to Faraday's law of induction, a changing magnetic field induces electrical currents, eddy currents, within the conducting track. By Lenz's law, the eddy currents in the track always create a magnetic field that opposes the change in the magnetic field, which created the eddy currents in the first place. So, when the pod with Halbach arrays moves over the conducting track, an opposing magnetic field is created by the eddy currents, thus creating a lift force enabling levitation. Suspension is an important part of any moving system. The suspension provides stability, safety, and balance to the system. There are several companies are working on this project, and the design of the pod is different. Due to exceptionally high stiffness and low movement space inside the tube. Air-bearing suspension system best for maintaining high-speed stability. Aerodynamic and pressurized air-bearing suspensions are superb for the Hyperloop system. And it is the future. Let's join our YouTube channel to learn more about Hyperloop technology. Thank you. Let's grow up, never stop your learning.